It's good to see you all. But I never knew you guys were so shy, so one of you approach the microphone and ask us questions so that we can refresh our memory.
Sprint!
Oh my god, could you imagine? Everyone just like...
We might
go,
not have
go for it.
How you could look at this man and act? I looked into his eyes yesterday and I almost lost myself.
Isn't she talented?
I don't know.
I mean, I thought the same thing every time. She's managing to act.
She did.
She's the first one.
Remember her name? I was just like, it's
okay. No, I didn't. I just immediately just, you know.
Wow,
I was going to get really inappropriate. I'm really tired. Thank you that there's a child. I just remember their story.
Sorry.
So, I have a question for you, Katee.
Yeah.
In Riddick, you did a cutesy.
Yeah.
And I know you got permission from your father, but did you ever think that people would look at a nude scene and actually find it somewhat empowering because you are a beautiful woman with a very athletic build, and it was a very different nude scene from what we've seen. So
right.
Can you tell us what was your thought process and why you agreed to do something?
Yeah, you know, first of all, I was a huge fan of the Riddick series. Up to that point, and Vin, and David Tui, and you know, I love the role, and I'd never really done nudity. I mean, I'm sure Jamie had, like, needlessly seen my boobs on set before on accident. but I never really, like, you know, did it before, so I called my dad and I asked permission. And my dad, and I said, it's only a 3 to 5 second push-in. And he was like, what is a 3 to 5 second push-in?
Wow. Why does anyone ever ask me a question like that? Who are you dating? 3 to 5 seconds.
And he, you know, ultimately was like, it's totally fine. You've waited this long. It's you know, no one's going to think that that's what you made a career off of, whatever. I found it to be interesting in a sense that, you know, that this is, it was a woman, a lot of women have asked me why I wanted to play a role that was sexist and misogynistic, and I actually never for one second saw that. I saw a woman who, quite the opposite, when someone looked at her sideways, she punched him in the face, so if anything, she was the problem. But I found her to be really strong and capable and interesting and very gritty, and that scene was gritty. And so, you know, I don't know. I mean, is it gratuitous? Maybe. But it's just a tit. I mean, it's not like I was spread eagle, like, watching my armpits with my hoo-ha out. That would have been wildly inappropriate. That would have walked out pregnant. Like, it was just a boob for 3 to 5 seconds.
Thank you.
You know?
Thank you for spreading positive body image. Thank you.
Thank you. Go eat a burger. Or a vegetarian burger. I don't know in Texas if you guys are vegetarian.
Woo! One of us.
One of you.
Two. Okay.
You're not pregnant as well.
Please leave.
Hi guys, thanks Marcus. Katee, I have to say, again on Riddick, you absolutely looked badass whenever you had the actual hoverbike at that moment, and you actually like held your arms out and actually just dropped it down kind of slowly, but although it looked really heavy, but you had it.
Thanks. I was actually flexing my muscles in that suit.
I saw it in IMAX and it was just like, BAM! this is a question for both of you. What was it like on your first days for Battlestar Galactica, on your first day versus your last days?
Scary versus sad.
Well, the first days, we were kind of thrust into boot camp, actor boot camp. Where we kind of had to like go spend the night for like a night or two and eat MREs and you know pretend like we were.
What were we eating?
MREs.
What's that?
MREs. Yeah, that was the food that it used to peanut butter constipates you.
Yeah, that's right.
No,
I think I remember they were called that last one.
Yeah.
No, we went to boot camp.
Yeah, we went to boot camp. I cried because they just cut my hair off.
That's true.
And I cried in the bathroom at 2 o'clock in the morning.
I had my own room.
You had your own room. I was with Bryce.
I was the only one that had my own room. I don't know what else.
We had a party in the room.
You missed out.
No, it was weird though, wasn't it? It was fun. It was fun in a strange way. It was scary at first. Nobody was talking, and we were hustled out of a bus and ordered to line up. And it was like, I don't know, we were in the middle of nowhere too. We'd been driven off down the freeway for about 2 hours in Vancouver. I'd never been to Vancouver before. Didn't know where we were in the woods. Felt all wrong.
In the woods.
Felt wrong.
We were in the middle of nowhere. Is that a 7-Eleven?
I didn't see 7-Eleven. But then by the end of the fear factor had worn off, and Ron Blecker, who was running the thing, who was a former ranger, was really mean at first, and like a drill instructor, and like shouting at
us. We thought we were going to die.
Yeah, it did feel like, I don't know, and Michael Reimer, the benevolent Australian director, whose idea this was, he waved us off sort of nicely, but he had no idea where we were going like that. As far as I was concerned, you know, we could have been abducted, and the strange man was telling us strange things, and we had to call him Master Chief, which I thought was odd. Apparently, that's a military thing, but I know that now. But, so yeah, that was kind of weird. And then I learned that Candace can't run at all. We had to do laps.
It was so
Candace weird. Can't run. Okay, so Candace made to run. She was out of the back and she just can't run. I thought that was intriguing.
It was funny too, because we had to do the obstacle course.
Yeah.
And the captains had to pick teams. And I don't even remember who the captains were, but it literally was Tomo and all the girls on one team, and then all the boys on the other team. But I think you maybe had Candace on your team, I'm not sure.
They went to carry her, didn't we?
But we won, because we all shoved Tomo over the huge wall, and then he just stayed at the top and went, whoop! there were legs flying over this wall. And we won because of that.
Tomo's never stopped doing that since. My first day on set, though, was my birthday. I do remember that. And I remember, I was convinced I was going to be fired from the time that Edward James almost got cast as my dad. And then I met him, and it was immediately apparent to me that he'd asked for me to be fired. So it was my birthday, I got to my trailer and there was a bottle of champagne there, and I thought that they're buying me off already. And they walked me to the set, and I think David Icke was there, and he showed up, he's the producer, and I thought, oh no, he's going to fire me. And it went on and on all day long, and I felt like that all the way through the miniseries, actually. But yeah, my birthday was the first day, and we should cut to the end.
Yeah.
The last bit was, what was it like? It was like, because we were away in the Okanagan.
No.
Where were we?
We were shooting at the Okanagan, but the last day was on set.
The last day was on set, and there was two units, and you all finished and went off to the bars, and I was still there.
No, I actually went home. That's what the one thing that I remember about the end is that when we wrapped, it was like 5 in the morning, 6 in the morning, and I wrapped and I just left. Like, I didn't even say goodbye to anybody, and...
No, it was anticlimactic.
It was very weird.
We'd already had the wrap party.
Yeah.
So it was really strange. We were running over, probably, and it was like five. And I was doing a second unit running around the, what do you call that ship where the Cylons live?
I don't remember.
Anybody?
The Baystar.
Baystar. Running around the Baystar shooting people with some supporting actors and none of the main casts. And we'd gone on longer than the main unit. And all day long was just this sort of, you know, pictures and signing things and just hugging everyone. And it was very emotional, but it did go on way too long. I had to catch a flight back to LA with my family, I think 3 hours after. So it was a strange kind of shuffle out the back door. A bit like my first day where I was convinced I was going to be shuffled out the back door. Thankfully, it wasn't. Yeah,
good
question.
I'm making myself laugh. All right.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks. Thank you. We could have answered that in like one sentence.
Just 20 minutes. With a moderator.
My name's Haley, and I've had the pleasure of meeting Katee a number of times, so my question is for Jamie. I was just wondering, the arc of your character, obviously, since you didn't think you'd make it through the miniseries, but did you have any idea, as Lee developed, you know, that you would end up the president.
No, of course not.
You were the president? I also have to recommend that you guys watch the show.
I had no idea. I mean, going back to a question, I think you had a question. Other than making me feel stupid. I mean, none of us at the beginning knew, you know, where we were going to go. I honestly, I didn't think really much beyond my first day, let alone the miniseries. And we very nearly didn't get picked up to a series. So there were many sort of stages along the way where I realised the show changed for me. And, you know, getting there for season one to start properly making a series in the US for the first time for me was really very exciting. And I had no idea, other than, you know, Lee wasn't very comfortable in his flight suit, so I knew that maybe, you know, as we kept going, I think I pushed them and begged them to sort of change things for me, because, you know, you're making a saga like this, there's very few people, there are other challenges for someone like Lee who's ambitious and doesn't